how many ways can you join your data without using traditional SQL joins? As SurrealDB is a multimodal database, it has different ways of joining data together. In this video, we'll cover the document model. We'll start off with embedded records, which are a key component of document-style databases. If we select star from person, we can see the whole person record. The key thing to notice here is that the address field is an embedded record. What that means is that instead of the address field containing the primary key to an address table, like in a relational database, we can denormalize the data such that we can skip making joins entirely when we want the full information for the person record. A trade-off we are making here is wanting faster queries by using more storage space. Working with embedded records is simple. We can select just the address field to get the address record, or in other words, the address object. To select the field inside the object, we can use a dot notation, for example, selecting the coordinates field. To select just the first item in the coordinates array, we can use a bracket notation. There is no limit to the depth of objects and arrays you can embed inside a record, allowing you to model complex data scenarios and navigate them simply with a combination of dot and bracket notation. This brings us to record links, which enable you to create normalized data models by linking records together. If we select star from review, we can see that this table is primarily made of record IDs pointing to other records. In SurrealDB, we don't use a primary and foreign key pairs. Instead, we use the record IDs, which are like primary keys that we just directly embed in places where a foreign key would otherwise be. This allows us to traverse from record to record without needing to run a table scan query, because the query planner knows exactly what table and record the ID belongs to. Therefore, it just directly fetches the record instead of searching for a needle in a haystack. Working with record links is as simple as working with embedded objects. You simply use a dot and bracket notations as if the data was all embedded in one record. You can also select multiple fields and have them be grouped together under the product object. Or you can alias them and have them show up as individual fields. There is a lot of flexibility here. Notice also that this completely eliminates the typical complexity and errors people make with joins, such as not knowing the grain of the data and whether you need a left, right, inner, outer, lateral, or cross join. Making the wrong choice here can lead to a lot of headaches and perhaps some angry database administrators. Now, you might be wondering, what is the trade-off behind the magic of record links? The key trade-off is referential integrity, which, while important, is not always needed. But when it's needed, we have a way to preserve referential integrity using graph traversal that we'll cover in the following video. That's all we have for you today. If you like this kind of content, make sure to like and subscribe and tell us what you want to see next in the comments below.